First of them were 1, 7, 4. Mass we offer for the repose of the soul of John Paul, but we'll especially remember John at the altar so that the Lord may grant John eternal fast. I confess to Almighty God and to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary of Virgin, for all the angels and saints, And to my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
While the Jews demand miracles and the Greeks look for wisdom, here we are preaching a crucified Christ. To the Jews, an obstacle that they cannot get over. To the pagans, madness. But to those who have been called, whether they are Jews or Greeks, a Christ who is the power and the wisdom of God. For God's foolishness is wiser than human wisdom, and God's weakness is stronger than human strength. The word of the Lord. Stand in God's presence. Praise to you, O Christ, King and Eternal Lord. I am one of the Lord's disciples. Everyone who believes in him has eternal life. Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal life.
Scattered the money changers' coins, knocked their tables over, and said to the pigeon sellers, "Take all this out of here, and stop turning my father's house into a market." Then his disciples remembered the words of Scripture, "Zeal for your house will devour me." Jews intervened and said, "What sign can you show us to justify what you've done?" Jesus answered, "Destroy this sanctuary, and in 3 days I will raise it up." Jews replied, "It has taken 46 years to build this sanctuary. Are you going to raise it up in 3 days?" But he was speaking of the sanctuary that was his body. And when Jesus rose from the dead, the disciples remembered that he had said this, and they believed the scripture and the words he had said. During his stay in Jerusalem for the Passover, many believed in his name, and when they saw the signs that he gave, Jesus knew them all and did not trust himself to them. He never needed evidence about any man. He could tell what a man had in him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise.
The liturgy of the third Sunday begins with the acknowledgement of God's holiness and his claim on us that we belong to him. It recognizes the fact that we are his own people and must live in a way that reflects his holiness. God offers us the gift of faith as a path towards holiness, and at the same time, we all want and desire to live a peaceful life in accordance with God's will. We all want to make a sense of our existence. We all desire to live a life where we can make a positive contribution to ourselves, to our families, and to those around us. Challenges are always with us. Difficulties surround us. However, the more we know, desire, and develop a personal and ultimate relationship with Jesus, our best friend, there is absolutely nothing that we cannot face and overcome. Indeed, we become the power and the wisdom of God. Today's first reading teaches us that the Ten Commandments are the basis of our religious and spiritual life. Instead of restricting our freedom, the commandments really helps us to love and respect our God and our neighbors. and in the second creating, which reminds us that we must appreciate the divine foolishness of the crucified Christ and obey his commandment of love as our expression of divine virtue. Now, today's gospel gives us a dramatic account of Jesus' cleansing of the temple, of its merchants and money changers, followed by a prediction of his own death and resurrection. And Jesus reacts with anger to abuse in the temple, which he perceives as a violation of the covenant, and shows himself as the Lord of the temple. He draws the traders out of the temple and predicted that he himself would be the temple of the new people of God. The synoptic gospel places cleansing of the temple immediately after Jesus' triumphant arrival in Jerusalem on the back of a colt on Palm Sunday, while John places it at the beginning of his gospel. Jesus cleansed the temple which King Herod began to renovate in 20 BC. The abuse which kindled the prophetic indignation of Jesus, by the conversion of God's temple into a noisy marketplace, by the animal and merchants, and into a hideout of thieves, by the money changers, with their grossly unjust business practices, sacrilege in God's place. Jesus' reaction to this commercialized faith was fierce. Since no weapons were allowed in the temple, Jesus constructed his own, a whip of cords, and used it to drive out the merchants and the money changers from the court of the Gentiles. Dear friends, we need to avoid calculating mentality in divine worship. Our relationship with God must be that of a child to his parent, one of mutual love, one of mutual respect, and a desire for the family's good, with no thoughts of personal loss or gain. Hence, fulfilling our Sunday obligation, only out of fear of mortal sin and consequence of eternal punishment, is a non-Christian approach. In the same way, obeying the commandments and doing the acts of charity merely as a prerequisite of heavenly reward are acts driven by a profit motive of which Jesus would not approve. And let us ask ourselves these questions during this third week of Lent. Can leading worship simply become a business for the clergy for which they are paid off? Do the laity sometimes think that they are paying the minister to do the worship for them, thinking we pay them to do it for us? Do we think of God as a vending machine into which we put our sacrifices and good deeds to get back his blessing? Do we use our acts of obedience to the Ten Commandments as a bargaining chip with God? The theologian Karl Rahner puts it simply: the number one cause of atheism is Christians. Those who proclaim God with their mouth and deny him with their lifestyles are what an unbelieving world finds simply unbelievable. Dear brothers and sisters, we need to always remember that we are the temple of the Holy Spirit. Saint Paul reminds us that we are God's temple, body and soul, because the Spirit of God dwells in us. Therefore, we have no right to desecrate God's temple by impurity and injustice. We are expected to cleanse our hearts of pride, hatred, jealousy, and evil thoughts, desires, and plans. Reminiscent of what Jesus did in cleansing the temple, we as 21st century disciples must, with his grace, cleanse ourselves of attitudes and behaviors that prevent us from seeing and responding to the hurt wherever we find it. Let us welcome Jesus into our hearts and lives during this season of Lent.
by repentance and the renewal of our lives. We will drive out the wild animals that do not belong to the holy temple of our body by making a bill of course out of fasting, penance, and almsgiving during the season of Lent, and by going for a good confession to receive God's love and forgiveness in the sacrament of reconciliation. The Lord continue to bless us, and during this celebration of the Eucharist, we ask the Lord for this grace, first and foremost, to understand and to remind ourselves that we are the temple of the Holy Spirit. May God bless us. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, God from God made, consubstantial with the Father. So from all things were made, for us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified and a Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world. We should pour forth prayers at all times, dear brothers and sisters, but above all, in these days of Lent, we ought to watch more intensely with Christ and direct our petitions more fervently to God.
Let us pray for our parish community, that God, who has begun the good work of drawing us together in faith, will continue to perfect this in Lent. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Let us pray that all may experience the mercy of God, who never tires of forgiving. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Let us pray for the Church, that the Pope, bishops, priests, and people may receive the Lord's blessing, and that it may be a place of ardent prayer, moral guidance, and reconciliation. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Let us pray for the grace to grow in holiness and conduct ourselves with devotion. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Let us pray for all those parts of the world torn apart by conflict and religious persecution, that by opening the hearts of your people to love, we may put an end to the numerous wars, conflicts, and persecutions. Let us pray especially for the negotiations currently going on, that they will succeed in bringing a pause to the conflict in Gaza, humanitarian relief, and ultimately a cessation of hostilities. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Let us pray that the life of every human person, from conception to death, will be revered and protected in our laws. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Let us pray for the sick of the parish, especially Barry Hall, Maureen Cowan's John Coulson and Margaret Askew, that they may find comfort to bear their suffering and fortified by the real presence of Christ in the Blessed Sacrament, and that they may soon be delivered from their suffering. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
Let us pray for those who have died recently, and for those whose anniversary falls at this time, that they may rest in the peace of Christ and inherit the promise of eternal life. Let us pray for a few moments in silence for our own petitions. Now let us bring together all our petitions as we say together, Hail Mary.
Hail Mary.
Blessed be the Lord. all creation. But for your goodness, we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of God. Bless you, Lord. Blessed are you, O God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. For the wine and work of human hands, it will become God's grace. Brothers and sisters, let this sacrifice and yours be accepted to God the Almighty God. May the Lord accept sacrifices here among us, for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church. Be pleased, O Lord, with these sacrificial offerings, and grant that we who beseech pardon for our sins may take care to forgive our neighbor through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you will that our self-denial should give you thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and so help us to imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you with countless angels, as with one voice of praise we are praying. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your Holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and to govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant, Pope Francis, Stephen, our bishop, and all those who call you to the truth, hand it on to the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servant, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion known to you. Father, we offer you this sacrifice of praise, for they offer it for themselves, and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and praying their homage to you, eternal God, living and true. In commemoration with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious Ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our Lord Jesus Christ, with Blessed Joseph, his spouse, your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from the eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O Lord, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and uphold these offerings in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hand, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said to bless, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory."
Give us this year our daily bread,
our sin and save from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will. Will you even reign forever and ever?
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you.
and system. You are sent from this assembly to bring the word of God and the bread of life to the sick and the humble members of our family. Go to them with our love, our care, and our prayers. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and King.
Receive the bread of things yet hidden in heaven, and are nourished while still on earth with the bread that comes from on high. We humbly entreat you, O Lord, that what is being brought about in this mystery may come to true completion through Christ, O Lord.
Amen.
Let, O Lord, we pray, the hearts of your faithful, and in your kindness, grant your servants his praise, that abiding in the love of you and their name, they may fulfill the whole of your command through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I take your remainder of the coffee morning today. Please, you know, from Rushmore, come from the other side. Today I will free studies at St. Paul's Hall and be here. So, let's. I wish you a wonderful week ahead. Keep well, God bless you. The Lord be with you.
With
your mighty God bless you, the Father and the Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. We want to announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Signal 4, 5, 4.